The President of the United Nations General Assembly calls for collective action on hate speech. Abdullah Shahid says it has been worsening due to the spread of disinformation and fake news on social media. Shahid spoke in a special UN session on Monday to mark the International Day for Countering Hate Speech.
To address this challenge in a comprehensive manner, we must cultivate our global cooperation and stand united, embracing the collective spirit that this great institution was designed to foster and that hate speech seeks to completely undermine. Hate speech is an inherent threat to our values and principles.
Three people are injured after Ukraine reportedly attacked Crimean oil drilling platforms in the Black Sea Monday. The head of Moscow-controlled Crimea says search is underway for seven others who remain missing. Ukraine has yet to confirm if it was responsible for the incident. The attack comes as Ukrainian President Volodymyr Zelensky said they are engaged in complex negotiations to unblock grains trapped in Black Sea ports by Russia's naval blockade. The European Union has accused Russia of sparking a global food crisis due to its blockade, calling it a real war crime.
Ukraine acknowledging difficulties in the fight in its eastern region as Russia gains ground on two cities. President Zelensky says fighting has been the most difficult in Severodonetsk and Lysychansk. The governor of the Luhansk region, where those two cities are located, asserts Russian forces now control most of the Severodonetsk. Moscow's intensified offensive comes ahead of an EU summit this week, where European leaders are expected to officially welcome Kyiv's bid to join the bloc. Over in China, hundreds of thousands are evacuated amid the country's heaviest rainfall in decades. Rainfall in at least three provinces in southern China reached 621 millimeters. That's the highest since 1961. Residents in Shaoguan City are staying in schools converted into temporary shelters. All in all, officials say nearly 480,000 people are affected by the rains and floods across the country. The downpour has also swelled waterways in the Pearl River Basin, threatening China's manufacturing and shipping operations. Authorities peg the cost of damage so far at around $254 million.
The fatal shooting of a Filipino lawyer in Philadelphia could be a case of mistaken identity. Citing police sources, Philippine Consul General in New York, El Mercato, said the gunman appeared to have fired at the wrong vehicle that was similar to what he was chasing. John Albert Lilo was riding in an Uber with his mother when he was shot in the head Saturday. They were on their way to the Philadelphia International Airport. He died hours after the incident. Lilo was in the U.S. to visit his relatives.
The mayor of Philadelphia blames the lack of gun control measures in the U.S. for Lilo's deadly shooting. On Twitter, Mayor Jim Kenney wrote, "The incident is another horrific example of the tragic impact of the prevalence of guns in their city." Kenney also said, "Senseless violence will always be unacceptable, and Philadelphia authorities are on top of the situation." The Filipino community in Philadelphia, meanwhile, held a vigil for Lilo.
Over in New Zealand, several Filipinos were among those who died in a road crash in Pictonstown. Authorities say seven people were killed in the incident, among them a baby. They were on their way home after attending a funeral when the van they were riding on collided with a truck. An investigation is underway. On Facebook, Philippine Ambassador to New Zealand Gary Domingo said the embassy is assisting the family of the victims.
Back here at home, the Metropolitan Manila Development Authority does not see the need to further expand the number coding scheme anytime soon. It says it has been monitoring a decrease in the number of vehicles using the main Metro Manila roads amid rising oil prices. The MMDA, however, says it's up to the next administration whether it will impose the expanded number coding scheme.
Nakikita po namin na wala naman pong pangangailangan sa ngayon dahil po patuloy na nababawasan ang bilang na sasakyan sa ating lansangan at moderate pa lang naman po yung traffic. May kabuuan na pong kabawasan na 27,000 from the time na before elections. At ang tingin po namin na malaking factor dyan ay yung patuloy na pagtaas ng presyo ng produktong petrol.